Hey guys, it's Todd, and today we're going to be looking at the song Lord I Need You by Matt Maher. One of the questions we want to ask ourselves with this song is what is appropriate for us to play? How little and how much do we need to play on this song? And also, what kind of sound can we use for this song? Typically with this song, if you've heard it before, it starts really soft, and so we kind of want to think about, you know, maybe using a piano or a pad type sound. If you're not familiar with a pad sound, it's just a really warm, kind of wraps around the music type sound. And one of the words that we can use to summarize a pad sound is just really subtle and soft. And so that kind of sound, if you have it on your keyboard or you have access to that type of sound, will really add to this music. But we want to ask ourselves the question, what does our band environment look like? And that's different for everybody. But if you're playing in a band with no acoustic guitar or no electric guitar or anything like that, maybe we don't want to use a pad patch because we're going to have trouble, whoever's singing might have trouble like hearing the structure of the chords. Since a pad patch is so smooth and kind of wraps around things, it's really kind of hard to tell where the chords start and where they end. So maybe if you're in a band environment where it's just you or it's just another piece or two, maybe you play piano on this song. And one of the things we want to look at when we're approaching this song, it's a slower tempo song at 75 beats per minute. We're going to be playing it in the key of B flat. That's a guy key for this song. If a girl was singing it, maybe we would play it in the key of D. And so that's also a question to ask yourself. If you're playing this song at your church or in a worship environment or wherever, and a girl is singing the song, more than likely you're going to do it in the key of D or somewhere around there. So as you're listening through and rehearsing, if that's the case, just be prepared to transpose it to that key. But for today's purpose, we're going to play it in B flat. And we want to look at probably the main thing with this song is just chords with different bass notes. And if you're not familiar with that, that just means that, you know, sometimes in this song, we're going to be walking up and we're going to have different bass notes than we're going to do in our right hand. And I'll kind of show you what that looks like. For the verse, it's pretty straightforward. We're going to be playing a B flat second inversion. So it's going to sound like this. And then we're going to go up to an E flat first inversion. So it's. Then it goes to a 5 chord, an F chord, up to the 6, which is a G minor, 5. Just like that. So it goes 6, 5, 4. And that's pretty simple for the verse. And then we want to pay attention to the dynamic of the second verse at the end of it, where it just kind of goes to the 1 and it holds. Right there, we're playing a 4 chord, an E flat first inversion over a 1 chord, a B flat. So we started playing the B flat second inversion, then we went to the E flat first inversion over the B flat, just like that. And that's what we're going to do kind of leading into that second chorus. And so that's one thing to keep in mind. And then when we get into the chorus, I'll show you the chords there. We are going to be playing a 1, 4, 1, 5, 6, 4, 1, 5. Here's where it gets tricky, and it's the chords with the different bass notes. 1/3, that's a B flat over a D. 1/3 sounds like that. Up to the E flat. Then we go down here for a B flat over F. That's a 1/5 chord. And then a 4/6 chord, which is an E flat over a G. Back down to a 1/5. straight five, one. So I'll play that one more time for you because it's pretty confusing, and if you need to slow it down, no problem. But that's going to be the trickiest part of this song, is just playing those different, you have a B flat up here and a D down here. It's just a chord with different bass notes. So that's just, once you wrap your head around that, it'll be a whole lot easier. But the chorus again is 1, 4, 1, 5, 6, 4, 1, 5. And here's the tricky part. 1/3, 4, 1/5, 4/6, 1/5, 5, 1. So that's the trickiest part of the song, and the only other thing to keep in mind is when we get to the bridge, as we're counting the bridge, you might have a tendency to say, this song switches from 3/4, which is three counts in a measure, to 4/4, which is the four counts. The song is in 4/4, but when we get to the bridge, it actually just cuts the last count. So it gets a little bit confusing, and if you count that out, we're going to be playing a four chord, 1/3, 5, 6, right? And when we get to that six chord is when the measure starts over, but we actually haven't counted to four, we only did three. 1, 2, 3. So we kind of start over the measure, and that's a little bit confusing, but just know when you get to the bridge, we're gonna actually cut off a count each measure that we're playing through that. So that's something to keep in mind, and again, if you need to slow it down and take it piece by piece, you can totally do that. But our chords for the bridge again are the four chord, 1/3, 5, 6, right? So that's the only kind of tricky part, is we're playing that 1/3 chord, which is the one with the different bass note, and we also cut one count out of the measure. And so we want to keep that in mind as we're playing. We want to ask ourselves, what is my band environment? And again, as you listen through this song, just ask yourself, what kind of instruments I hear, what I can add to the music, and how I can make it as unified as possible. And so remember, have fun as you're playing. Get a setup that's easiest for you, that makes it super simple, and just enjoy the process as we play Lord, I Need You by Matt Maher.